Heshima kwa wema wake na upendo wake na pia kwa neema ya kuwa hapa kwa ushirika wa katikati ya juma. Tumshukuru kwa sababu ya kutuwezesha kuwa na siku njema na kila mmoja wetu akapata nafasi ya kuwa katika nyumba ya Mungu. Pia tunampa Mungu utukufu kwa kutupa nafasi ya kuweza kumwabudu na kumsifu. Neno lake latuambia kwamba tunapo msifu, tumsifu with a joyful heart, kwa mioyo iliyo na furaha. Na namshukuru kwa sababu ya furaha na amani ambayo ametupa jioni ya leo. Kwa hivyo nataka nichukue fursa hii niweze kuwakaribisha nyote katika nyumba ya Mungu jioni ya leo. Tuweze kushiriki neno lake ambalo amepanga kwa ajili yetu. Najua ya kwamba tutakapotoka hapa tutatoka tukiwa tumebarikiwa. Naomba tuweze kuomba kwa ajili ya neno. Mfalme mkuu, Baba wa rehema, uketie kwenye kiti cha enzi. Ni wewe ambaye umetupa nafasi jioni ya leo mahala hapa. Tunajua Bwana, kila wakati unapokutanisha watoto wako uko na sababu. Na kwa hivyo jioni ya leo Bwana, tutumaini Mfalme ukaweze kujidhihirisha kwa njia ajabu katika maisha yetu. Roho Mtakatifu wa Mungu, tunaomba ya kwamba utaweza Mfalme wa ajabu kutuunganisha na mbingu yako. Maana Bwana, tunaamini ya kwamba the right time we have connection with your kingdom, you are able long to release that what is for us, almighty Father. Kwa hivyo jioni ya leo Bwana, tunyenyekea kwako ya kwamba mioyo yetu Bwana utaweza kuinenea, na Bwana utaweza kutupa nguvu, maana wewe ndiye mwenye nguvu. Tunainua madhabahu yako mahala hapa na kuinua jina lako katika kikao hiki Jehova, ya kwamba yale yote ambayo Mungu umepanga nasi yataweza kutufikia jioni ya leo. Tukutukuza Bwana, maana umetupa nafasi kama hii ili tuweze Bwana kushiriki. Kama vile Bwana mitume wanatufunza in Acts chapter number 2 verses 42 mpaka 45. Tunaelewa ya kwamba Bwana walikuwa nakusanyika na kuweza Bwana kugawa neno lako kwa pamoja. Walikuwa nakusanyika na kukula pamoja. Walikuwa nakusanyika na kutiana moyo. Walikuwa nakusanyika pia na kuonyeshana njia Mfalme wa ajabu. Tuko hapa Bwana jioni ya leo ya kwamba Roho wako mtakatifu ataweza kutuonyesha njia. Roho wako mtakatifu ataweza kutuongoza. Roho wako mtakatifu ataweza kutupa nguvu katika jina lako Yesu Kristo. Kwa hivyo Bwana tunyenyekea chini ya ukuu wako, ya kwamba mapenzi yako Bwana katika maisha yetu jioni ya leo yataweza kutimia Jehova. We humble before thee, O Lord. As I speak your word to your children, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart shall be acceptable before thee, mighty Lord. And God, as I speak your word, it shall enter in the hearts of your children, O God, and it shall be able to bear fruit in their lives. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise be to God. Once again, I want to take this opportunity to welcome you. That we shall share the word of God, the one that Jehovah has prepared for us. I would like to say that I'm still born again. The Lord Jesus Christ is my Savior. I love Him for the far I am today, knowing that it is all by His grace, it is all by His power, it is all by His goodness and mercy that I am where I am today. This evening, I would like us to speak about giving. We shall speak about giving, and now as we speak about giving, we are speaking about giving as an act of worship. Praise be to God. Giving as an act of worship. When we worship God, there are many ways of worshiping God. And before I start mentioning those ways, I would like to say that when Jesus met the Samaritan woman in the book of John chapter number 4 verses 21 to 24, He told the Samaritan woman, when the Samaritan woman was trying to argue about their worship and telling Jesus that their forefathers were worshiping in the mountains, and Jesus wanted to show her the kind of worship that is acceptable before the Lord. And God told the Samaritan woman that the time is coming when the children are going to worship the Father in spirit and truth. I would like to say that God is looking at the worshipers that are lending to worship Him in spirit and truth. That whenever we worship God, the Holy Spirit of God is in control of our worship. Every time we worship God, there is truth in our hearts. And when we speak about truth, we are talking about being acceptable before the Lord. When the Lord looks at our hearts, is it acceptable before Him? Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So this evening, as we talk about giving as an act of worship, there are many other ways of worshiping God. We can worship God through songs. We can worship God through offerings. We can worship God through other services, like even coming to offer services in the church. That there are services that are not seen. There are services that people cannot see because you not do them here in the pulpit when people are looking at you. That is also a way of worshiping God. We also worship God through praying. We worship God through helping others, serving others. But today I would like us to concentrate on giving as an act of worship. Praise be to God. When we define the word worship, worship means paying great honor to something or somebody that you love and admire. Praise be to God. So if you love somebody and you admire that specific person or something, it means that you are giving them a great honor. And when you are giving them a great honor, it means that you are worshiping them. So, if you are giving whatever you have, your riches, the great honor in your life, it means that you are worshiping them. If you are giving your couple the great honor in your life, it means that you are worshiping them. If you are giving your businesses or your children or everything that you have greatest honor in your life, it means that you are worshiping them. And therefore, as believers, we are called to give great honor to our Almighty God, who is above everything. And this is why God commanded the Israelites in the book of Exodus when he was giving the Ten Commandments. And he said that you should not worship any other God but me alone. Praise be to God. Therefore, this evening, I would like us to read the word of God from the book of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter number 9. We shall read verses 6 to 15. 2 Corinthians chapter number 9, verses 6 to 17. Now, to 15. Now, as we read this, 2 Corinthians chapter number 9, verses 6 to 15, it is talking about generosity. Now, the writer says this. Remember this. Whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gift to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. Now you supply seed to the sower, and bread for food will also supply and increase store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. Verses 12, this service that you perform is not only supplying the needs of the Lord's people, but is also overflowing in many expressions of thanksgiving to God. Because of the service by which you have proved yourselves, others will praise God for the obedience that accompanies your generosity in sharing with them and with everyone else. And in their prayer for you, their hearts will go out to you because of the surpassing grace God has given you. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. Praise be to God. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. We thank God for that. Now, this is Paul encouraging the Church of Corinthians in this chapter 9. He is encouraging generosity. Let me start by saying that when we worship God, as I have said before, through giving, it is good that we know, as we have defined the word worship, that first of all, you have to love and to admire and to give great honor. You have to love and to admire in order to give great honor. And when you give great honor, it means that you are worshiping that specific person. Worship is determined by two things. The knowledge that you have about one determines the kind of worship that you will give that specific person. The knowledge that you have towards God determines the kind of priority that we shall give him when it comes to giving. The knowledge that we have towards God determines what we shall give him when it comes to giving. Number two, how much you love the one you worship. The love that you have towards God, the love that you have towards the one you worship, determines the kind of giving you shall offer him. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So, just like singing, praying, reading God's word, witnessing, evangelizing, celebrating Christ and also serving others, giving also is one of the major way of worshiping God. Praise be to God. Worship can never be complete without giving finances that are needed to support the work of God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Without offering what we have, we cannot be able to continue with the work of God. You realize that as we serve God, we shall need materials, what we call other materials. But we believe that as we worship God, as Paul has reminded us, he supplies what we are supposed to use as we go on with this mission. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I would like to say this. When we look at the Old Testament, during the Old Testament, giving was a law. It was a law that was passed that you must give. You must give the first fruit. When you are dedicating your children, you must accompany them with an offering. You must give for the cleansing of sins. So, in the Old Testament, it was a must when it comes to giving. But when Jesus Christ came, he changed the kind of worship in a way that now it was no longer must, but giving was by grace or was by love. Praise be to God. Now, people at this moment they give out of love. They are not forced to give. And I would like to say, the giving that is forced is not the light giving. Because when it comes to giving, you should first of all feel that I am giving to God as a way of worship. You should not give because people are giving. You should not give because it is a custom that has always been there, that if you are a believer, if you are a member of a certain church, giving is a must. This evening I would like to say that giving is out of love. When you give, there should be love inside you. Praise be to God. Not only to God, but even to your fellow people. Not only to God, but even when you are helping the needy, there can be no giving without love. Every follower of Christ must excel in the grace of giving, because we can see even the early apostles, because Jesus had taught them. Remember when he is praying for them and telling them, I will send you. And he is telling them, do not worry about what you shall eat, what you shall drink. But God shall always provide. I always believe that it is God who gives us in order to be able to give. Praise be to God. The people who come and give in the church, they don't give because they have a lot. They don't give because they want to show themselves. They don't give because they are above others, but they give because God has blessed them and they love God and they want to worship God through giving. Praise be to God. So, as We know as Jesus told the Samaritan woman, when we talk about giving, and because giving is also an act of worship, when Jesus is talking about worship, it doesn't only mean that when we sing in spirit and true body. It doesn't mean that when we pray in spirit and truth only. But he is also saying that when we are offering, when we are giving, when we are supporting the work of God, it is, should also be done in spirit and truth. Praise be to God. So giving is an expression of love. One asks for Jesus being part of worship. It is an expression of love. Because I love Jesus, I want to give. Because I love Jesus, I want to support the mission work. Because I love Jesus, I want to support the church. Because I love Jesus, I want to see a great church built where the Lord shall be worshipped. Praise be to God. Because I love Jesus, I want to see the church having its own land. Praise be to God. Because of loving Jesus. And the Bible says, when we read the Second Corinthians that you have already learned, chapter 9, verse 7, we see that God loves a willing and a cheerful giver. Paul is trying to show us that, first of all, when we give, there is something that God considers. Are you giving because you are willing to give? Are you giving because you are ready to give? Or are you giving because you are forced to give? Praise be to God. Because if you are forced to give, or if you are giving because others are giving, that is not a worship in spirit and truth. But the worship that is in spirit and truth is when you are giving willingly and also cheerfully. Praise be to God. So, a willingness to be generous in giving is more important than the amount itself. God will never consider the amount. God will not consider the quantity of what you give. What God considers is the act towards giving. Praise be to God. When I am giving, how is my act? One day, when people are offering in the church, and the Bible says, a very elderly woman came to offer. She earned a coin. And the Bible says that Jesus looked at her. You know, when God looks at us when we are giving, he does not only look at our outside appearance, but he also judges the heart towards giving. And when Jesus judged the heart of that woman, he said that this woman who is giving today, there is no one in this room who has done what she has done. Because she has given all she has, all her tender. Praise be to God. So, when we give, when we offer, when we serve God, the Bible says that let us serve him all her tender. In other words, whoever has been given much, much is expected of them. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kama umebarikiwa zaidi, hivyo ndivyo Mungu anataka ubariki kazi yake zaidi. Jina la Yesu lisifiwe. Praise be to God. And as we give, there is something that David shows us in Psalms 24, I mean in 1 Chronicles chapter number 29. And also the same Psalms 24 verses 1 to 2 reminds us that. David, a great servant of God, reminds us that. Number one, everything that we give belongs to God. You remember the time that David gathered the people that they may build God the temple. And the people started bringing materials. They started gathering materials. And when David was praying, when they were committing those materials before the Lord, this is the prayer that David prayed that day. Open with me, First Chronicles, chapter number 29. First Chronicles, yule amepata, naweza kutusomea. First Chronicles. Na amepata. First Chronicles, chapter number 29. Okay, verses 14, listen. Now this is David's prayer when they have gathered all the materials for the building of the temple. These were the gifts for the building of the temple. I'll read only because of time, verses 14. But whom am I, and who are my people that we should be able to give as generously as this? Everything comes from you, and we have given you only what comes from your hand. Praise be to God. Note that. You're saying, God, that, okay, we are brought here to build the temple. But whatever we are brought, Lord, this is not ours. It is yours. In other words, you're telling God, we are just stewards, taking care of what is not ours, but what belongs to you. And we are coming to bring back what belongs to you. Praise be to God. The same one, we can see it in Psalms chapter number 24. Psalms chapter number 24, verses 1 and 2. Psalms chapter number 24, verses 1 and 2. These are the same ones of David. He say, the earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, the world and all who live in it, for he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. So, when we talk about giving, and when we look at David is trying to show us that when we come to give, when we come to support the work of God, we are not giving God what is ours. In other words, we are returning what belongs to Him, to Him. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And therefore, it is good to know that giving is a way of showing God loyalty. We don't give that we may make God rich. We don't give because the kingdom of God is suffering poverty. We give because we want to show God we are loyal to you, Father. And when we give, we want to show God that we love you, we admire you, and we want to give you because you are our God. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So, when we talk about giving, there are reasons why we should give. And as I speak these reasons, it is good for us to know that the plans that are ahead of us, each and every one of us knows them. And as I speak this, it is good that we put this in our mind and in our hearts. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. First of all, we have seen that God loves a cheerful giver. We have also seen that when we are giving God, we are giving Him because we love Him. We admire Him. We want to show Him the greatest honor. We have also seen that as Jesus told the woman, the Samaritan woman, in the book of John chapter number 4, 21 to 23, that giving, being also an act of worship, should be spirit and truth. Praise be to God. Now, reasons why we should give. Number one, we should give because God gave us first. Praise be to God. Mungu ndiye alitupea kwanza. God is the one who gave us first. Remember, in the beginning, there was nothing. Because everything starts in the beginning. And God created everything. And when he created everything, if you read Genesis chapter number 2, I think verses 15. Genesis chapter number 2, verses 15. This is what God told the man when he created everything. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden. The Garden of Eden that he had prepared everything. The Bible says every fruit was there. If it is what he had already created. If it is animals, they were already there. So he took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work in it and told him, take care of it. Praise be to God. Therefore, when we give, we should always remember that it started with God. When he gave to us, and he told man, I have given you everything that I have created. Take care of it. Praise be to God. When I was speaking at Came on Sunday about worship, God gave me a revelation there that when he told man to take care of it, he didn't call man to come with jembe and panga to kupalilia ile garden. But he told man, take care of it. In other words, he told man, you are in charge now. Worship me through it. Praise be to God. But Yesu asifiwe. And this is why you will see him calling Cain and Abel and telling Cain and Abel, offer to me a sacrifice. Praise be to God. Come and offer to me. In other words, he is telling Cain, I have blessed you.